IQ is made possible in part by Wing to Wing Foundation. Today, these two teams, Huntington High School from Huntington, West Virginia, and Ripley High School from Ripley, West Virginia, compete on today's HiQ. From the Cool TV studios, here's the host of HiQ, Ernie Anderson.
Thank you, MJ McKay. Thank you, folks. Welcome back to our two teams. You've seen them. We're doing double elimination this year, so you've seen them before, and we're going to get kicked off with the warm-up round. And Cameron and Huntington, we'll start with you. Physical science question. What type of elementary particle and a fundamental constituent of matter combines to form composite particles called hadrons, the most stable of which are protons and neutrons, the components of atomic nuclei?
A quark?
Quark is right. Your physical science question now, Shay and Ripley. From the Greek roots for equal and place, what is defined as two or more types of atoms that have the same atomic number and position in the periodic table and that differ in nucleon numbers due to different numbers of neutrons in their nuclei?
Isotopes.
Isotopes is right. I'll stay with you for foreign language pronunciation. In Italian, it's che ore sono. In French, it's quel heure est-il. In Spanish, it's que hora es. What is the English?
What time is it?
It's about 1:30. Oh, no. All right. You're right. All right. Your foreign language question now, Cameron and Huntington. In Italian, it's come il tempo. In French, it's quel temps fait-il. In Spanish, it's qual es el clima. What is it in English?
What is the weather?
Is right. And we hope we have a lovely day today. Stay with you for dynamic markings in music. When you see DIM on a piece of music, it means a decrease in loudness. It's the abbreviation for what 10-letter word? Cameron?
Decimo.
No. Shay?
Diminuendo?
Diminuendo is right. Back, I'll stay with you for another dynamic markings in music. The dynamic marking FF means very loud. It's an Italian word that literally translates to very strong. What is that 10-letter word?
Fortissimo.
Fortissimo is right. You're at 40, 20 for Cameron and Huntington in the early going. Staying with you for a 2022 Grammy audio question. This duo won for Record of the Year, Song of the Year, Best R&B Song, and in a tie for Best R&B Performance during the 2022 Grammys. Listen and name the song and the duo.
What you doing? What you doing? Where you at? Where you at? Oh, you got plans. You got plans. Don't say that. Shut your trap. I'm sipping wine. Sip. In a row. Trip. I look too good. Look too good to be alone. Ooh. My house clean. House clean. My pool warm. Pool warm. Just shake. Smooth like a
play the whole song. Shay, your answers. Okay, time. Huntington.
Leave the Door Open, Silk Sonic.
Is right. Good for another 10 points. Brings you to 30. Bruno and Anderson. Grammys for you now. Here's a cut from the second collaborative album by this duo, his 61st and final studio album, of and her seventh. This won the Grammy for Best Traditional Pop Vocal Album and Best Engineered Album Non-Classical. Here's the album's title song. Name it and the duo.
Who will buy?
Who would like to sample her supply? Who's prepared to pay the price
for a trip to paradise?
Cameron, your answers.
No answer.
All right. Shay. Your answers.
Lady Gaga and Tony Bennett.
And the song. You had that. It's Love for Sale, so no points there. And that will end a good warm-up round. Back for the bonus round when HiQ returns.
Before gathering with family and friends this holiday season, don't forget to stop in your local Food Fair Market and pick up holiday trays of wings, meats, cheeses, and veggie platters. Also, Food Fair features only Black Canyon Angus quality meats, cut and prepared fresh daily, ready for your holiday meals. Serve only the best on your table this season. Food Fair, from our family to your family, wishing you a safe and joyous holiday celebration.
For those on the go, the smoothie connoisseur, the break room favorite, and for those that just never quite have it all, happy holidays from Clark's Pump and Shop. Stop in this winter weather season and warm up with one of our coffees, hot chocolates, or lattes, custom made just the way you like it. Clark's Pump and Shop. Return, refresh, refuel.
The views are breathtaking. The experience is hands-on. The instruction is personal. The programs are nationally ranked. The atmosphere is welcoming. It's all here, all in one unique place at Morehead State University, all to help you soar higher.
Chris, I think people see our commercials and they want us to tone it down.
Oh, like everybody else.
I'm on TV showing you a row of cars.
Low prices. Cars have outsides and insides.
Explosions!
Families with a dog.
Price.
For families and a dog.
Fireworks!
And look at this dollar sign.
Maybe not.
Right now at Dutch Miller Kia, get a 2023 Sportage starting at just $269 a month.
And welcome back to IQ after our warm-up round, a 10-point differential in favor of Ripley. We'll get into the bonus round here in a moment, but let us talk to Cameron and Huntington High School up on the hill. You get nosebleeds up there, I hear.
Yeah, you're right, Ernie.
I've been up there many times for football games and all that, so tell us about your school.
Yeah, you're right. We're located on the hill in Cabell County. Our coach is Mrs. Kelly Coffer. Our head principal is Jody Cunningham. We have about 1,700 students, and everybody from Huntington High wants to give a big thanks to D and MJ behind the works here.
All right.
So thanks, nice guys.
Nicely done. The Highlanders are in the house, and Ripley, what's your team's nickname?
The Vikings.
The Vikings, yes. All right. Shay, tell me about Ripley again.
We're located in Jackson County, West Virginia. Our principal is Mr. Merritt. We have around 800 students that go to our high school, and our coach is Miss Barbara Heckard.
Barbara Heckard. Welcome back, folks. We're getting ready for the bonus round. We'll kick it off with you, Shay, and the fine folks from Ripley with your 15-point clue on French literature. 15-pointer. This French historical novel, first published in 1862, is considered one of the greatest novels of the 19th century.
Next clue, please.
In the English-speaking world, the novel is usually referred to by its original French title. However, several alternatives have been used, including The Wretched, The Poor Ones, The Wretched Poor, The Victims, and The Dispossessed.
Les Miserables.
Les Miserables, right. Gives you another 10 for 50. And now, famous authors. I'll give you some works. You name the author. For 5 points, Bartleby the Scrivener and Moby Dick.
Herman Melville.
Uh-huh. For 10 more, The Sound and the Fury and As I Lay Dying.
Faulkner.
Uh-huh. And Silas Marner and Middlemarch.
I delegate Sydney.
No, not Coleridge. You can pick up the 15 if you know Cameron and team.
Ernest Hemingway.
It's George Eliot, who was actually Mary Ann Evans. For you now, a historic park question for 15. This is a major park in central London. It's the largest of four royal parks that form a chain from the entrance of Kensington Palace.
10-point, please.
The park is divided by the Serpentine and the Long Water Lakes and was established by Henry VIII in 1536 when he took the land from Westminster Abbey and used it as a hunting ground.
5, please.
Speaker's Corner has been established as a point of free speech and debate since 1872, while the Chartists, the Reform League, the Suffragettes, and the Stop the War Coalition have all held protests there. In the late 20th century, the park was known for holding large-scale free rock music concerts featuring groups such as Pink Floyd, the Rolling Stones, and Queen. Name this historic park. Any guess, Cameron?
Central Park.
No? Always good to guess. It might be right. Shay? Your answer for five?
No answer.
It's Hyde Park, Dr. Jekyll. Bonus round now for you, Shay. 15-pointer on astronomy. Many think this is a constellation, but it's actually an asterism, a group of stars that were first recorded in the 2nd century by Egyptian astronomer Ptolemy.
Andromeda?
No. So you can take the 15 if you guys know up there.
Can we go to 10 or no?
No. Good try to confuse an old man. How about it?
Orion?
No, I would have said the group of stars is named after the Latin for larger bear than the 7 brightest stars. Form the name by which we know Ursa Major is also the Big Dipper. So nothing there. But back to you for a chemistry class question. 15-point clue. This is a common piece of lab equipment with a 2-word name used to measure the volume of a liquid. Want to move to the 10?
Can we have a 10, please?
Sure. It has a narrow cylindrical shape. Each marked line on it represents the amount of liquid that has been measured.
A graduated cylinder?
Is right for 10. Brings you to 40. And now your bonus, and it'll be our final bonus, on Through the Ages. For 5 points, archaeologists generally divide prehistoric eras into 3 ages. The Stone Age, the Bronze Age, and which 3rd age?
The Iron Age.
Correct. Now for 10 more. Period between 1750 and 1850, when the dramatic advances in manufacturing, transportation, and technology produced powerful changes in the economy and culture, it was named the Blank Age.
The Industrial Age?
Is right. Now to take the lead for this 15-pointer. During the 17th and 18th centuries, the world went into an age of cultural movement promoted by such luminaries as Isaac Newton and Voltaire, based on faith in nature and toward knowledge through science and reason. This was the age of?
The Age of Enlightenment.
Is right for 15, and that will bring the end to a well-played bonus round. Now, our 60-second round categories will be Yo, Alternating Whips and Chains, Foreign Food, and Hodgepodge when HiQ returns.
Other banks love when you overdraft your account so they can charge you more fees.
That's not totally true.
Other banks have strict policies in place and they're not always able to help their customers.
We do have strict rules and policies to follow.
But we understand that life happens. At Members Choice Credit Union, you're a name, not a number.
Return. Refresh. Refuel.
Happy holidays from Clark's Pump and Shop. Stop in this winter weather season and warm up with one of our coffees, hot chocolates, or lattes, custom made just the way you like it. Clark's Pump and Shop. Return, refresh, refuel.
Before gathering with family and friends this holiday season, don't forget to stop in your local food fair market and pick up holiday trays of wings, meats, cheeses, and veggie platters. Also, Food Fair features only Black Canyon Angus quality meats, cut and prepared fresh daily, ready for your holiday meals. Serve only the best on your table this season. Food Fair, from our family to your family, wishing you a safe and joyous holiday celebration.
The views are breathtaking. The instruction is personal. The experience is hands-on. The programs are nationally ranked. The atmosphere is welcoming. It's all here, all in one unique place. All to help you soar higher.
Welcome back to HiQ. Good first half. We have Huntington at 70, Ripley at 65, which means Ripley gets the choice. First choice of the 4 categories of Yo, alternating whips and chains, foreign food, or hodgepodge. Shay, what do you like?
Foreign food.
Foreign food it is. Okay, start the clock. What two words on a French menu tell you the potatoes are topped with cheese?
I delegate Jillian.
Au gratin. What gives Russian borscht its red color?
Beets.
Uh-huh. The meat in the famous German dish, Sauerbraten.
Pork?
No. Miso. The basic ingredient in Japanese cooking is food paste consisting chiefly of what legume?
Soy.
Uh-huh. What do Israelis call light dumplings served with a savory filling?
Pass.
What Spanish rice dish includes meat, seafood, veggies, and almost anything else?
Pass.
In Casablanca, if you're served steamed, processed wheat with meat and veggies, you're eating what?
Pass.
What Swedish word means open sandwich table, a buffet with a variety of foods? And time runs out. You picked up three, bringing you to 95. Cameron and team on the foreign food question. The meat in famous German dish, Sauerbraten.
Sausage.
Your answer?
Beef.
It is beef. What do Israelis call light dumplings served with a savory filling?
Meat pockets.
It's niches or knishes. What Spanish rice dish includes meat, seafood, veggies, almost anything else?
Paella.
Paella. Es correcto. El teno puntos. In Casablanca, if you're served steam processed wheat with meat and veggies, you're eating what?
A TV dinner.
Ooh, I love me some couscous. What Swedish word means open sandwich table, buffet with a variety of foods?
A lazy Susan.
Oh, I love me some lazy Susan stuff too. Smorgasbord. So you picked up three, and that will bring you to 100. Now, which of the remaining categories interest you?
Yo, please.
Yo. Start the clock. All your answers begin with the letters Y-O. Inside an egg shell.
Yolk.
Toy that has its ups and downs.
Yo-yo.
Transform your body and mind with it that originated in India.
Yoga.
Sierra Nevada National Park.
Yosemite.
Precedes and the Restless and Jeezy.
You.
No. Alpine singer.
Yodel.
Uh-huh. Dannon competitor.
Yoplait.
Frank Oz provided his voice in a series of famous movies.
Pass.
Boo Boo's friend or first name of baseball legend.
Yogi.
Uh-huh. In terms of population, it's Japan's second largest city, less than a half hour from south of Tokyo.
Yokoshima.
No. You got them all in time. You picked up 4-7. Brings you to 170. So of the three, Ripley and Shay, that they missed or passed on, begins with the letters Y-O, proceeds, and the Restless, and Jeezy.
Pass.
It's Young. Young and the Restless, and Jeezy. You soap opera fans out there. Frank Oz provided his voice in a series of famous movies. Answer?
No answer.
Yoda, which is a lousy imitation. In terms of population, it's Japan's second largest city, less than a half hour from south of Tokyo. Your answer?
No answer.
Is Yokohama. And that will end the 60-second round. Back to Stump the Experts when we return with HiQ.
The views are breathtaking. The experience is hands-on. The instruction is personal. The programs are nationally ranked. The atmosphere is welcoming. It's all here, all in one unique place at Morehead State University, all to help you soar higher.
Chris, I think people see our commercials and they want us to tone it down.
Oh, like everybody else.
I'm on TV showing you a row of cars.
Low prices. Cars have outsides and insides.
Explosions!
Families with a dog.
Price.
For families and a dog.
Fireworks!
And look at this dollar sign.
Maybe not.
Right now at Dutch Miller Kia, get a 2023 Sportage starting at just $269 a month.
For those on the go, the smoothie connoisseur, the break room favorite, and for those that just never quite have it all, happy holidays from Clark's Pump and Shop. Stop in this winter weather season and warm up with one of our coffees, hot chocolates, or lattes, custom made just the way you like it. Clark's Pump and Shop. Return, refresh, refuel.
Before gathering with family and friends this holiday season, don't forget to stop in your local food fair market and pick up holiday trays of wings, meats, cheeses, and veggie platters. Also, Food Fair features only Black Canyon Angus quality meats, cut and prepared fresh daily, ready for your holiday meals. Serve only the best on your table this season. Food Fair, from our family to your family, wishing you a safe and joyous holiday celebration.
Welcome back to High Q. After three rounds of play, it's Huntington High School 170, Ripley at 95. These points are 20, each question 20 points apiece. And Huntington, Cameron, will start with you with a visual question. Here's a work of art by Hieronymus Bosch from the late 1400s to early 1500s, now housed in the Museo del Prado in Madrid since 1939. This work of art is divided into three sections hinged together. What is the term for that?
A trifold?
No. Shay?
Triptych?
Triptych is right. So another 20 for you. Brings you to 115. Now your visual question. Name this work or tell me what the right and left panels represent. So either answer. This work or the right and left panels, what they represent.
I delegate Jillian.
The left panel represents Earth and the right panel represents Hell or the underworld.
No. Huntington.
The left panel represents heaven and the right panel represents hell.
No, we're looking for the Garden of Earthly Delights is the name of the work.
Okay.
Or Garden of Eden. And it's the Last Judgment, Final Judgment, Day of Reckoning, okay. Day of Judgment, Judgment Day, Doomsday, or Day of the Lord. So we strike out on that one. But I come back to you, Shay, for types of speeches. When you want to educate your audience about a certain topic, you probably opt to create this type of speech. Its purpose is to simplify complex theories into simpler, easier to digest, and less ambiguous ideas. It can be speeches given by staff members in meetings, paleontology lecture, just about anything from a teacher. What is this 11-letter type of speech beginning with the letter I?
Informative.
Informative is right. Quick answer there. Brings you to 135. Now, Cameron, your types of speeches. This is a special kind, a persuasive speech, where the speaker encourages the audience to pursue their own well-being. By injecting confidence into the audience, the speaker is able to guide them toward achieving the goals they set together. For example, a sports team pep talk is considered to be this type of speech, where the coach encourages his players by creating a sense of unity between one another. I Have a Dream by Martin Luther King Jr. is an example of what 12-letter type of speech?
Motivational.
Is right for another 20. That brings you to 190. Staying with you for famous trails. Which trail, pioneered in 1821 by William Becknell, was used by the U.S. Army in the 1846 Mexican-American War to invade New Mexico?
The Rio Grande Trail?
No. Shay?
No answer.
It's the Santa Fe Trail. Now your trails question. The eastern part of this trail spanned part of what is now the state of Kansas and nearly all of what are now the states of Nebraska and Wyoming. The western half of the trail spanned most of the current states of Idaho and its namesake state. Name it.
Oregon.
Oregon is right for another 20 for you.
Brings
you to 155.
You said it and it messed me up.
190 for the team from Huntington. And now, staying with you for an American literature question. What 19th century poet wrote Song of Hiawatha? Was it Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, Walt Whitman, James Fenimore Cooper, or Emily Dickinson?
James Fenimore Cooper?
No. Cameron?
Longfellow?
It was Longfellow. Gives you another 20, brings you to 210. Now, your American literature question. What writer of the Harlem Renaissance wrote Their Eyes Were Watching God? Was it Langston Hughes, W.E.B. Du Bois, Claude McKay, or Zora Neale Hurston?
Langston Hughes.
No. 20 for you if you know. Shay and team.
Or Neale Hurston.
Hurston is right, 420. And that ends another well-played game. We'll see who moves on.
This HiQ broadcast has been brought to you in part by River Cities Builders, A&A Porta Potties, Kentucky Farmers Bank, Stoltz Pharmacy in Greenup and McDonald Pharmacy in South Shore, First and People's Bank, Clark's Pump and Shops of the Tri-State, Moorhead State University, Tri-State Area Food Fairs, Dutch Miller Automotive, and Members' Choice Credit Union with funding provided by the Wing to Wing Foundation.
Other banks love when you overdraft your account so they can charge you more fees.
That's not totally true.
Other banks have strict policies in place, and they're not always able to help their customers.
We do have strict rules and policies to follow.
But we understand that life happens. At Members Choice Credit Union, you're a name, not a number.
The views are breathtaking. The instruction is personal. The experience is hands-on. The programs are nationally ranked. The atmosphere is welcoming. It's all here, all in one unique place. All to help you soar higher.
The Professor and Stephanie, weekday mornings from 6 to 10. MJ McKay, middays 10 to 2. Ernie G. Anderson, weekday afternoons from 2 to 6. Jim Forrest, evenings from 6 to 9. Dwayne Elliott, weeknights 9 to midnight. And the greatest songs of all times play here on Cool Hits 105.7.
Thank you, and welcome back to HiQ. When the smoke is cleared, it's Huntington defeating Ripley 210 to 175. So next week, this Huntington High team will meet previous winner Boyd County. Ernie G. Anderson, reminding you to adopt a spayed or neutered pet for a lifetime of love. God bless you. See you next week here on HiQ.